Mark the start of a relationship, but to acknowledge and strengthen a bond that already exists. This ceremony is a public affirmation of that bond, and as their dearest family and friends, it is our honor and privilege to stand witness to this event. This day is made possible not only because of your love for each other, but through the grace and support of your family and friends. It is our hope that your fulfillment and joy in each other will increase with each passing year. Vincent and Elizabeth, in the days ahead of you, there will be stormy times and good times, times of conflict, and times of joy. I ask you to remember this advice. Never go to bed angry. Let your love be stronger than your anger. Learn the wisdom of compromise, for it is better to bend than to break. Believe the best of your beloved rather than the worst. Confide in your partner and ask for help when you need it. Remember that true friendship is the basis for any lasting relationship. Give your spouse the same courtesies and kindnesses you bestow on your friends, and say, I love you every day. Despite all of our differences, love is what we all share. It is the great unifier, our one universal truth, that no matter who we are, where we've come from, what we believe, we know this one thing: love is what we're doing right. That's why you're both standing here, and that's why your family and friends are here to watch you stand up. We have all lived our own lifetimes, and in this moment, we're reminded that the ability to love is the very best part of humanity. All of us here today have our own love stories. Some are short, others are long. Some are yet unwritten, while others are just getting to the good part. I'm here, we are all here, because we want the very best for you. We're here to hope with you, to support you, to be proud of you, and to remind you that love is not happily ever after. Love is the experience of writing your own story. It's not one moment, not even this moment, it's every moment. Big ones like saying I love you and moving in together. And then there are a million little ones, falling asleep next to one another, spending holidays with your families, making dinner together, binge watching Netflix shows or Sunday football, go Cowboys or whoever, getting a hug when you come home from work. These everyday moments fuse together into one big experience. And even though this experience is so incredible, Words fail us when we try and explain it. That's just the way it is with love. It is meant to be felt, not described. Marriage is a commitment in life where two people can find and bring out the very best in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other human relationship can equal, a physical and emotional joining that has the promise of a lifetime. While the commitment begins with the two of you, its effect radiates outward. It touches your family and friends and ultimately all of society. When this commitment is seriously made and continuously fulfilled, it leads to the richest and most rewarding of human relationships. Your relationship will take more than love. It will take trust to know in your hearts that you only want the best for each other. Dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow, even when it is difficult to do so. And faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for you both. Your joining together today becomes all the more important to recognize the significance of a devoted and affectionate family life. Seeing that no moment is without meaning, we ask that you take this marriage as the beginning of your lives together. Today signifies the creation of a new home and a new family for you both. May you be fulfilled by each other's love and friendship. May you be overjoyed by the promises you are about to make and the life together you will create. Remember that in every marriage, there are good times and bad times, times of joy and times of sorrow. Marriage is a journey, a time of adventure and excitement enhanced by the love, trust, dedication, and faith you have in each other. May the promises you make to one another today be lived out to the end of your lives. Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joys, but today is the day it all begins. Vincent and Elizabeth, do you, with your family and friends as your witnesses, present yourselves willingly and of your own accord to be joined in marriage? If so, say we do. Will you promise to care for each other in the joys and sorrows of life, come what may, and to share the responsibility for growth and enrichment of your life together? If so, say we will. All right, you ready? Repeat after me. I'm Vincent. Now look at take you, Elizabeth, to be my lawful wedded wife. I give to you in the presence of God and these witnesses my promises to stay by your side in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, through the good times and the bad. I promise to love you without reservation, comfort you in times of distress, encourage you to achieve all of your goals, laugh with you and cry with you, grow with you in mind and spirit, always be open and honest with you, and cherish you for as long as we both shall live. You all right? Good? Okay. You can take a second. Hold on. Get your laugh on, girl. Your turn. Hi, Elizabeth. Is it from Vincent?
Thank you, Vincent.
To be my lawful wedded husband. I give to you the presence of God.
I give to you the presence of God.
And these witnesses.
I
promise to stay by your side.
I promise to stay by your side.
In sickness and in health. In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
Through the good times and the bad.
The good times and the bad.
I promise to love you without reservation.
I promise to love you without reservation.
Comfort you in times of distress.
Comfort you in times of distress.
Encourage you to achieve all of your goals.
Encourage you to achieve all your goals.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Grow with you in mind and spirit.
Grow with you in mind and go with you.
Grow with you in mind and spirit.
Grow. Sorry, grow with you in mind and spirit.
Should I shorten it for you? Always be open.
Always be open.
And honest with you.
And honest with you.
And cherish you.
And cherish you.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as
we both shall live. Rings, rings. Having this love in your hearts, you have chosen to seal your vows by exchanging rings. From the earliest of times, the circle has been a sign of completeness. The rings that you have chosen to wear have neither beginning nor end, much like your love for one another. They are some of the words that you speak today. May these rings be from this day forward your most treasured adornment, and may the love they symbolize be your most precious possession. As you wear these rings, may they be constant reminders of these glad promises you are making today. All right, you first. I'm gonna go to this wall for you. You got fun here? Ready? I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and faithfulness to you. Did you pick that up? It is very nice. Yeah, yeah. All right, your turn. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my love.
Symbol of my love
and faithfulness to you. So when I was preparing the script, I asked the couple to send me at least 5 things they loved about each other. I haven't shared this with any of them or with any of you, so it'll be a treat. We will start with Vincent. She's a strong person. She makes me want to better myself. Her smile and dimples, I see the dimples. She has a huge heart and a caring person. She's a hard worker, go get her. And now for Elizabeth, brace yourself, please. Yeah. My 5 things I love about Vincent. He has an incredibly kind heart. He once found someone stealing from his car and chased after the person because they ran and come to find out it was a woman when he caught her. Of course, he let her go with no harm done. Just wanted to know what she took, which was change. Later on another day, he saw her again and gave her money. And I believe he told her not to be stealing. He tries to be strong for everyone, to be the rock, and forgets about himself. He's so selfless. I love how he's been so patient with me. I came into this relationship at a very low point in my life, struggling with keeping a family together, trying to save a family business, going from living a lavish life to family in bankruptcy, father's passing, and much more. I was angry at life and was very out of character at times, but he was patient and saw past my insecurities and flaws. I love how he pushes me to always be better at everything and anything. We both have grown in our careers. Always gives me his opinions on things, even if it's hard for me to hear, but it's always just to help me. I love everything about him, basically. That's great. Let us pray. Lord, bless the receiving and giving of these rings. May Vincent and Elizabeth be forever true to this union. May the seamless circles of these rings become the symbol of their endless love and serve to remind them of the holy covenant they have entered into today. Amen.
Amen.
Today you have pledged yourselves to a lifetime of loving for one another, loving and caring one another. May this be a commitment made in love, kept in faith, lived in hope, and eternally renewed. As you stand before us, it is our hope that you will go through life loving, trusting, and caring for one another, completely and forever. Having pledged their fidelity to one another, to love, honor, and cherish one another in the presence of this gathering, and by the authority vested in me, the state of Virginia has given me the authority to pronounce you husband and wife. You may seal your vows with a kiss. Y'all married now. Can I get everyone to stand, please? Turn down for what?
Turn out to what?